Hello, my name is Dennis Pons.
And I'm Rens Bierig.
We recently joined the TPRC as PhD students and are both working on a project called PERFECT, which stands for press forming without defects.
We both have a degree in mechanical engineering from the University of Twente. And during our masters, we became really enthusiastic about research on composite materials. After some professional experience in industry, we found our way back into research on composite materials with this project on stem forming.
I've worked at Anyform for 4 years, where I've helped to develop composite forming simulation software, and I've learned about the value of combining research and industrial applications. In my job, I was teaching people how to use the existing tools, and that gave me the desire to learn even more about the materials and processes that we're working with, an opportunity that I now have through this research project.
In our research, we focus on unidirectional materials. These materials gave more design freedom for the engineer, as you can make, for example, tailored paths, but it also allows for automated layup processes. Furthermore, it comes with better structural performance.
One of the challenges faced by manufacturers is the occurrence of wrinkles that occur in the very short time that the press closes. These wrinkles are not good for the final part performance, and hence we would like to minimize them as much as possible.
The relation between part design, process design, and the occurrence of wrinkles is not as straightforward, and this can really be a struggle for industrial manufacturers. Luckily, we've got process simulation tools, and with that, we're able to predict what occurs during the stem forming process. We're then able to modify the design on beforehand. With these process simulation tools, we enable industry for first-time right manufacturing of composite parts.
In our research, we try to improve the wrinkling predictions by measuring and describing the material behavior even better. For that, we're conducting controlled experiments to measure how difficult it is to deform the material when it is molten.
For example, I'm currently studying the friction between adjacent plies. We know that slippage between the plies is important to prevent wrinkling. From these controlled experiments, we now observe that it is a complex startup behavior. And we think that these transient effects are actually very important for our understanding of the formation of wrinkles during the stem forming process.
And I'm currently developing a new method to measure so-called in-plane shear deformation, which allows to extend the material over complex shapes. We measure the force required to deform the material at different temperatures and velocities to better understand the material behavior. Again, the in-plane shear deformation is required to form the material without wrinkles.
With the data from these controlled experiments, we try to develop constitutive models to describe the material behavior mathematically. With these material models, we are then able to predict the material response under arbitrary deformations that we didn't yet measure.
Which brings us back to the simulations. Material models are an important aspect of this simulation and how it's capable of predicting the deformation in any stamp forming process. By improving the material models, we're improving the prediction of the forming behavior, and we're also improving how it predicts the wrinkles.
Here at the TPRC, we've got this fantastic opportunity to work with the entire chain, from the start of material characterizations up to real forming experiments with the press standing here. These experiments can then be compared with simulation predictions.
Also, the feedback and discussions with industrial partners are an invaluable aspect of TPRC that really adds value to our research as well as our experiences as a PhD.
We also get to work here with a fun group of young and talented researchers, and we're all very enthusiastic about working on the future of thermoplastic composites.
In the end, we hope that our research on stamp forming simulations will lead to better and easier manufacturing of thermoplastic composite parts, perhaps even enabling more complex parts for more demanding applications in the future. Thank you.